write anything or to draw anything or what you want to scribble on the whiteboard, which conveys or which you think your subject is, how you perceive your subject. So I'm just sharing a whiteboard with you all. You just have to put something in this, on this whiteboard to convey or how you perceive your subject. How you perceive your subject, just scribble anything or you, how you perceive your subject. What do you, what first thing comes in your mind when you think about the subject which you teach? This is how you perceive things. You perceive your subject which you teach, and the way you express comes out in the form of art. Maybe in the form of drawing, a symbol, or just a scribbling on the board, or a sign, or you write cursive handwriting. So it comes in the form of art.
And there's a lot of disturbance.
You perceive.
Lot of disturbance.
Yes. Teachers.
Please mute everyone. Please mute.
Yeah. Okay, so now this is how you perceive your subject, and when you have to express it, it comes in the form of drawing, it comes in the form of symbols, it comes in the form of some kind of scribbling. That is actually what art is. Please mute yourself, teachers. So this is how you perceive things, and that comes in the form of art. How powerful an art can be. The subject which you teach, how you perceive it, you are expressing in some form of symbol, sign, some diagram, is actually art. So here I introduce the topic for the day. All can see the screen? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so here I introduce the topic for the day, that is art as a powerful engagement tool. So how powerful it is, just now you must have realized, whatever you perceive, you try to express in some form, and that form is actually the art form. Let's get started. Here we have some good thoughts. With that, we will start. Tell me, I will forget. Show me, and I may remember. Involve me, and I will understand. So what art can do, we will see in this session, how it is going to involve students, how it's going to involve you all in the session. Some very good thought here. The problem is not how to wipe out all differences, but how to unite with all differences intact. Role of a teacher in students' engagement. The grass isn't greener on the other side. It is green where you water it. So it is all because of the efforts from teacher's side, which will help children to enhance their all their inborn skills. This is what does that mean actually? So it is not green on the other side. It is green where you water it. These are some beautiful thoughts. And these are the students benefit from an approach to education that engages all of their senses. As you all know, we have five senses which we perceive things around. We build concepts through sight, hearing, smell, taste, touch. These are the five senses and how art can be instrumental over here in engaging all these senses and then ensure the maximum learning. How art can engage all these senses we are going to see in this module. So the learning objective of the module, understanding of arts as pedagogical tool and its impact on the holistic development of a child. You are going to see familiarity with art experiences as a medium of creative self-expression. Skill of planning and organizing age-appropriate art experiences to make learning of different subjects appealing. So this is the learning objective of the module which you are going to do today. And three types of arts education in school: arts as curriculum, arts enhanced curriculum, arts integrated curriculum. So arts instrumental in all these, arts find scope in all these type of curriculum where you can integrate art with curriculum. Art can be used to enhance curriculum. Art can be as a curriculum. So let's see five ways art can improve school performance. Let us see. Teaching the whole child. The arts encourage and improve understanding of the self and a greater sense of confidence among students. So this is how it encourages the child and build confidence among children. Instilling a growth mindset. By learning about the arts, students can develop a range of essential skills, unlike more practical subjects like science or math. The arts require people to become emotionally involved. So we will see different types of arts where students can actually get emotionally involved. And improvement in cognition evidence has shown that learning music isn't just about the notes. It also helps to improve verbal memory, reading ability, executive functions, foreign language fluency. Improve communication. Communication is an indispensable skill at the core of humanity. Students can learn a variety of powerful communication skills by studying the arts. These are the some of the ways arts can improve performance in school.
Video जरूरी ऑन करना है.
Teachers, please meet yourself. A humble request.
रुको मैं टी-शर्ट पहनता हूँ फिर ऑन करता हूँ.
Okay, so the fifth one here, how art can improve performance.
ये ऑन करके झट मारेंगे बैठ के.
A deeper cultural understanding and a greater awareness of self. Art education isn't just about having a positive impact on student learning or dipping a brush in some paint and calling it a day. Culture cannot exist without art. Art lies at the core of human identity. And this is why the most important gift a teacher can give their students is an appreciation and understanding of art as well as the ability to create it for themselves. So these are the ways by which art can improve performances in school. What is art? Art is a universal form of communication and creative expression. It is often a language that expresses our experiences and perceptions of the world around us in varied form. So now art is broadly classified into visual and performing arts. Let us see some of the visual and the performing arts, how appealing they are, how convincing they are, and how they can involve the maximum senses of the children so that the learning becomes permanent. Your visual arts are art forms that create works that are primarily visual in nature, such as ceramics, drawing, painting, sculpture, प्रिंट मेकिंग, डिजाइन, क्राफ्ट, फोटोग्राफी, वीडियो, फिल्म मेकिंग एंड आर्किटेक्चर. सो दिस ऑल इंक्लूड्स, दिस ऑल कम अंडर विजुअल आर्ट्स. लेट अस सी सम विजुअल आर्ट्स. यर इज इट ब्यूटिफुल टीचर्स? इज इट अपीलिंग टू यू? Visually yes, appealing ma'am. Art. Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So, yes. This kind of art works so yes, visually appealing beautiful. To the children. Can involve this. Who will forget the beautiful smile of Mona Lisa?
That Mona Lisa.
So appealing. Lego art. These are visually appealing art. So, the two categories we are doing, visual and performing art. These are all many more we can include in visual art. I have cited only few because of the time constraint. You can have performing arts here. Basically, arts are that skills that require performance in front of a public audience. Examples, acting, singing, dancing. Other form of performing arts include opera, theater, magic or illusion performances, mime, spoken word, recitation and public speaking. So this comes under performing arts. Let us see some performing arts. Here you have your music on the stage. Here you can have this kind of performance on the stage. You can see, isn't it appealing, teachers? Yes?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So these are our performance on where you have audience and you are performing actually on the stage. You have drama. All these are so appealing. And how are we going to include all these in teaching? What is art integrated learning? First of all, let us see. Art, when integrated with different subjects, seamlessly become the medium of teaching learning process, and different concepts can be easily grasped in a joyful manner. So all these visual and performing arts are very instrumental in giving them real life experiences actually. So interdisciplinary approach over here, how art can be integrated with all the subjects which you teach: math, science, foreign language, native language, history, social studies, religious education, and art itself. So art finds its way where it can be integrated, or you can have an interdisciplinary approach with all the subjects which you are teaching in school. Why art education in why art integration in education? How it will be very useful here in education? How it is going to help? It reduces the curricular burden by making learning more meaningful and joyful. To enable holistic development, taking care of all the three domains, namely cognitive, affective, and psychomotor. To enhance the skills to communicate and power to express. To help the child become more sociable, to develop the aesthetic sense and enhance creativity among children. Art as a powerful medium of expression is a strong pedagogical tool. So that is why we need to have art integration in education. Here art will be instrumental in education. It will fulfill all the objectives which we actually set for the for children. So let us see. What do we mean by student engagement? What actually it means? Let us see, how are we going to engage them? How it's going to help? Objective of student engagement in the school: maximize learning in the classroom, develop healthy learning environment in the classroom. It will promote meaningful learning. It will monitor students' learning outcome. It will remove monotony or boredom, laziness, passive learning environment in the classroom. It will prepare alert, active, and smart global students who can think critically, minutely, and rationally. So this is how the objective of student engagement in the school. Let us go for next. Student engagement is the product of motivation and active learning. It is a product rather than a sum, because it will not occur if either element is missing. So it is a product of motivation and active learning, which can happen only when you integrate art with your subject. How are we going to do that? I have a few citation of the subjects, the core subjects, because of the time constraint, there are many, many more artwork which we can include in our day-to-day teaching. not only during assessment. So integration of art with four subjects. Let us see here, four subjects. How are we going to integrate? There are various ways where you can integrate art in your subjects. You can include all of them, or few of them, or one of them in your teaching. I'm not emphasizing on your day-to-day teaching. Regular teaching will not be possible, but somehow we try to include artwork in our teaching, some topic or some concept or some activity we can include in our teaching. Not regular basis, not possible, but definitely we can, as a role of a teacher, we can try our level best. This many we have, we cannot include all. Obviously, let's see some making puppets, masks, or costumes for characters, drawing or painting scenes or characters, creating clay models or constructions of buildings or environments, making props for recycled materials to act out this tool. Many more we can include in a day-to-day teaching. It depends upon the suitability in your subject. Painting a large picture for scenery or a mural, creating a collage, weaving, using drama and role play to stimulate language learning, convert a chapter to dialogue, role play, using questioning to promote thinking, lower order questions, higher order questions. So these are some of the ways by which you can integrate art in your subject. Not all, some may not be suitable, some are suitable for your subject. You can pick one, and definitely we can do a few of them, and we can make a subject. The teaching learning process will be very joyful. Of that process will become joyful. Languages. Languages, yeah, you all know, is an indispensable means of communication. Not only that, any subject, if to learn any subject, you require language. Without language, no subject can be done. And language is a skill that cannot be taught. It can be only caught. How are you going to develop those skills in children, where the children will develop the language skill so that the learning of the all the other subjects becomes easier for them? So like for you have language like English, Hindi, Marathi, Sanskrit, and many more other languages. How are you going to develop those skills? I have picked up some art form where you can include in languages. Not all was possible. Not all the topics was possible. Some of them, like you have figure of speech. Now figure of speech call as Alankar in Hindi. What we call in Marathi, Arti ma'am? Figure of speech.
Alankar.
In Sanskrit. Sunita ma'am.
Alankar.
These are the ornaments to actually decorate the language. So figure of speech is not language not meant to be taken literally. It's meant to create vivid images and include similes, metaphors, personification. So it is just like an ornament, and it will beautify the language. How it will beautify the language? So here you can give this beautiful activities to children. Instead of just telling them or explaining them the figure of speech, you can give them this kind of artwork where they will actually find some figure of speech here in their artwork. Like over here, you have your smile is as bright as the sun. The cloud is fluffy pillow. So your simile and metaphor is used in this artwork. You will introduce a figure of speech in this art form so that learning becomes more interesting for them. Not just introducing, I think many of the teacher, the English teacher must be doing this. So like the rain fell like small kisses on my face. The bright green blades of grass stand tall like soldiers on a battlefield. Love is like a blooming flower. So this form of artwork in English where you are going to teach figure of speech, you give an activity where children will draw some scenery, some beautiful diagrams where, or some pictures where they will find themselves the figure of speech which you are teaching them. So you need not directly introduce a figure of speech. you can give some brief idea about the figure of speech, and you can tell them to draw, or you can introduce some artwork where you can relate some of the figure of speech in that artwork itself. So here the art will be very instrumental to actually introduce figure of speech. Similarly, you can do for Sanskrit, Marathi and Hindi, where you call Alankar in Hindi and Marathi and Sanskrit as well. So a similar activity you can do for figure of speech. Now teachers, I need your help over here to identify this figure of speech. The slices of bread jump out of the toaster, suddenly scaring me. So this kind of exercise can be given to children to identify a figure of speech in the given images. So you find some images of very interesting ones where you can ask them to identify the figure of speech. Because you help me to find this figure of speech, tell me.
Personification.
Yes, very good. We'll go for next. The needle was this big.
Hyperbole.
Okay. Yes. Overstated.
Atishyokti.
Yes. You are as skinny as a rail and you are a mountain.
Antithesis. Simile and metaphor.
Simile.
Antithesis.
And what about the, and you are a mountain?
Metaphor.
Yeah, so this kind of activity.
You are a mountainous metaphor.
This kind of activity you can do with the children to identify the figure of speech under your study and when you're teaching. You can have many more. I've just included few creative writing in languages. This will be in English, Hindi, Marathi, what all the languages they are learning. Creative writing will help them to express the creative side of the child, the innate ability to write creatively. So you can do descriptive writing where you can tell them to describe this scenery. You can guide them with some few creative words. So this will help them to express their creative sides in writing. Some children are really good in writing. So you will encourage the children by giving such activity where they will describe this scenery. You can have many more beautiful pictures. I've just given one over here. So you can give a title to this descriptive writing. What title would you suggest, teachers, for this scenery? This beautiful scenery, how you can guide them for some creative words, some non-conventional words, which they normally they are using. Don't encourage those words. Please encourage some creative words where they can use in this description. Encourage them to give a title for this. What title would you suggest, teachers?
My dream house.
Yes.
Canvas painting by God.
Yes, very good. Thank you, ma'am. Many more. So to let them only give a title to this descriptive writing. So just allow them to think non-conventionally. Let them express their innate abilities. Let them have sublimation of their innate, their creative work. So next, story writing. Now, story writing, you will just try to give them some pictures, some images, where you will guide them to weave a story. You are telling them, you are actually giving them these pictures, where you will tell them to make a story on your own. Not the conventional ones or the stories which they know from the books. Let them create their own story, Per ka khazana, Chuha or Parvat, Jadui Nadi or a Jadui guy. Just tell them to make their own story, give name to the characters, find the moral of the story, and please allow such activities to children. It will be it will help them to enhance their language skills. Isn't it, teachers? You all agree with this? Yes.
Yes, yes. 100% we agree.
Yes. So these are these are elementary level you can do for the smaller children. This kind of creative writing you can encourage. Idioms, muhavre. So again, muhavre, that is idioms. How are we going to teach them? You all know teachers, you all are best in your job. I know that very well. It is just the revisit to what you are actually doing. So we are just reinforcing here. It is not something new I am teaching you all. You know all these very well. And I have included very few because of the time constraint. Here we have muhavre. So how are we going to do muhavre with them? Not just introducing some muhavre with pictures. If you do, that will be very interesting to the children. Nau do gyara hona, naak kaatna, hawa se baate karna. So this will be very interesting to them. Instead of just merely elaborating on the muhavre, this kind of picture depiction will be very helpful in developing language skills like muhavre. Here you have jiski lati uski bhais, that means shaktishali ki vijay hoti. You have dobi ka kutta ghar ka na ghat ka. This is how you are going to have some pictures to depict. Bhais ke aage beam bajana, arth murkh vyakti ko gyan ki baate samjana. This kind of picture depiction will give them a clear idea about the muhavre. So it will, things will not remain abstract with them. Then we will tell them to identify muhavre. Teachers will identify muhavre over here. This is how, once you introduce with those picture depictions, we can tell them to identify muhavre. Now teachers will help me to identify this muhavre. Four muhavres here, one by one.
Kala akshar hai barabar.
Yes. Then
अंदर क्या जाने अदरक का स्वाद
ऊँट के मुंह में जीरा
ऊँट के मुंह में शेर पे सवा शेर
very good, well done. So this is how this can be very interesting to teach muhavre. Do you all agree with me, teachers? Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is how I think most of you are doing. You are best in doing your job. This is just a reinforcement through the artwork. So mathematics is not the subject. First of all, it is the language in which God has written the law of universe. And the fear of mathematics in students, the art over here will be very much instrumental to remove that fear of mathematics. There are many, many activities, many approaches towards learning mathematics. I was not able to include all over here, but definitely we will see a few of them. How are we going to make mathematics joyful? How can we make the abstract ideas in mathematics can become concrete with the help of arts? So here we see, when we are teaching them circle, not only circles that with the help of a compass, they are doing some geometrical work with the compass. So that to break that monotony, we can tell them to have some circular designs. Give them one design to do. Let them try. They will come to know the use of the compass in the geometry box and how beautifully they can use that instrument. And the application of the circle to have this kind of beautiful designs in circle. Next, you can have, when you're teaching shapes at elementary stage, to children, that time when you're teaching them rectangle, square, circle, all these shapes will have some application in making some kind of figure. Like I have picked one here, the Ganesha figure over here, where you children can use different shapes. That becomes very interesting for them. It is not just merely learning about the square, about the rectangle, about the triangle, but how it finds its ways in the art, and that makes mathematics more interesting to them. Three-dimensional shapes. Now, 3D shapes here we can introduce with these kind of models. and we can ask them to do one or two, like simple ones, cube and cuboid, and we can tell them to find, or when we give the universal law to them to find the volume of a cube or a volume of a cuboid or total surface area of a cube or a cuboid, you tell them to make one project or make one cuboid with the measurement of your choice, or then find volume or find total surface area of the cuboid. That makes the concept of mathematics more concrete for them, and that abstract thing about just looking pictures in the book will not be that helpful to them. And it will develop that interest in mathematics. It will help to overcome the fear in maths. Isn't it, teachers? Yes?
Yes, miss. Very good.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Symmetry, the concept of symmetry. You see symmetry.
Lovely butterfly.
You show them these beautiful designs, ample number 101 designs which you have, show symmetry. I picked one. You show symmetry in nature, how mathematics find in nature, how you see mathematics in the real life. You show some kind of this kind of artwork to show symmetry. That will be very interesting to them. The graph not only used for plotting x and y axis or solving equations with the help of graph by plotting points. Here you can give them some extended learning for when you're teaching plotting points on graph. So this is a graph paper art. Isn't it beautiful, teachers, how their boxes are used of that graph? It will be very interesting for them. Isn't it? Yes.
Means through cross stitch also we can...
Yes, yes. Many more.
Yes,
many
it's
more.
Really very nice.
There are 101 activities, interesting activities in art, which can be integrated with mathematics. So over here, fractal in arts. So here they will see the beauty of mathematics. The calculation of mathematics is not always boring. You can get such a beautiful fractals with the help of mathematical calculation. So that this will develop that love for maths teachers. So I need to stop sharing and we will get disconnected very soon, teachers. You have to rejoin because the meeting is going to end in a minute. So I'm going to end the meeting here. We will join again. Hopefully you will rejoin, teachers. Please rejoin. I'm ending the meeting.
Yes, yes.
Here. Yes.
Yes.
All have joined, yes. Will we start? Okay. So this is how we can show how mathematics can be so interesting, not only those the boring calculation. It will help to overcome the fear in maths. Let's go for. So when you are teaching parallel perpendicular lines or intersecting lines at the elementary stage, when they are building concept in maths about this line, you have to illustrate with pictures with some real life examples where they will actually relate to the real life those mathematical concepts, not only in the book. So how mathematics find application in real life. We have a video on this. One more concept we can teach through an art form. Here, when you are teaching fractions and decimals in smaller classes, here you can give them an activity as an introduction to show how fraction can be done with the help of artwork. And this will be very interesting to them. Not merely introducing 3 upon 10 pi upon 20 like that, you can actually make the mathematical concept of fractions and decimal. It will become very concrete to them by doing this kind of artwork. So now I have videos to share for this, where you can show this kind of videos to children, very interesting ones that will help them to develop their interest in mathematics.
Rabu ma'am, can you please mute all the participants, please? Thank you.
Okay, so now you're...
Ma'am, still there is a lot of disturbance. Teachers should mute themselves.
Can you see the screen, teachers?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What about the sound?
Yes, ma'am, audible.
Audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes.
You find lines that are perpendicular on the rectangles perimeter. Or let's break it down even simpler to make right angles in particular.
Parallel lines never meet. Intersecting lines make these. Perpendicular lines meet at 90 degrees. Put your hands in the air with me. Parallel, intersecting, perpendicular, irrectangular.
Let's talk about detecting if two lines are intersecting. It's the term that we select if at any point two lines connect.
Parallel lines never meet. Intersecting lines make V's. Perpendicular lines meet at 90 degrees. Put your hands in the air with me. Parallel, intersecting. Perpendicular, irrectangular.
When two lines will never touch, then you can tell that those two lines are parallel. Like these telephone wires up above the street. Parallel lines will never meet.
Parallel lines never meet. Intersecting lines make V's. Perpendicular lines meet at 90 degrees. Put your hands in the air with me. Parallel, intersecting, perpendicular, irrectangular.
If she could help me find where to write one half on the number line, she said,
first draw a line with two arrows.
Then she sang a song, here's how it goes. My stuffed animal can't talk, but I thought I heard.
Hey Ben, on the number line, where's one third?
I said first draw a line with two arrows, and hey, I know a cool tune. Here's how it goes.
Very nice. It was amazing.
So here we will continue. Okay, so that was some interesting videos for students where they will find the concept of mathematics very interesting. So that can be done in elementary level where we are introducing such concepts of fractions, decimals, where you are introduced many, many videos we can find and many useful resources for mathematics. Here was not able to include everything. Okay, so here you have some maths websites where you will find beautiful worksheets, maze, games, puzzles, crosswords, readers, all this we will find in these websites. Buzz Math, Math is Fun, Dreambox, Math Playground, Mathway, Cool Math for Kids, First in Math, the Math Forum, Illumination, Absurd Math. All these are the websites where you will find all these resources, beautiful videos, all those interesting worksheets, the games, puzzles, and all that which we do in mathematics. So these are some websites. I'll share this with your teachers. Okay, so we will go for the next subject, science and art. Science plus art can create magic. How it will create magic? Let us see some of the activities which we can encourage children to do. First of all, science here, without the practical application, science the scientific concept will not serve any purpose. So the essence of science is that the scientific concepts find some application in real life. So that is the essence of science. And with art, it will create magic. Now let us see some of them I have included here, hands-on. You can give some small activities at home with the available things at home. They can prepare some simple electric motor. These are the some application in science where it will serve the purpose of teaching scientific concepts. Without that application, it is like a body without soul. So you need to, when you learn science, you need to have some activities, some kind of application in real life, because here you will find science, it's there in the nature. And the subject of science and art both have effect on each other. Children will develop the scientific approach towards art, and they will learn the art of learning scientific concepts. So these are the ways science and art will have an effect on each other. Some simple activity we can give to children, we can guide them for this. I picked only a few of them. There are 101 active, simple activities which we can encourage them to do, just not merely learning concepts, and things remain abstract with them. The Harry Potter magic wand, we can tell them to prepare by some simple, we can guide them for this. There are ample of websites which will help us to do such activities in science. Here you will explain them the different parts of the leaves by leaf rubbing activity. On a plain sheet, we can have this leaf rubbing activity where you will actually get the impression of the leaf and parts of the leaf can be labeled. So that will be very interesting to children, not by merely learning the labeling of different parts of the leaf. This kind of small activities will be very interesting in science. Here you have, you can tell children to practice at home, making soda experiments. They can prepare a small volcano at home by using the vinegar and baking soda. So these are the simple activities, and they will see the chemical reaction and the chemical change which will happen, and bricks effervescence that will act as a, you can tell them you are making a chemical volcano. So lots of gas will be released, and this is how you can guide them for some simple activities. This is a hands-on, the practical knowledge they will gain with the help of some simple activities. Now, some scientific concept can be introduced or can be reinforced or can be drilled with the help of poem. There are some scientific concepts like shadow, reflections, rainbow. They will find a scope in poem. So we can tell them to compose one, or we can give them some poem based on some scientific concept. So it will not remain very... you know, those scientific concepts, we explain about shadow, we explain about rainbow, reflection and all that concept remain abstract to them. So the poem will develop some kind of interest, some kind of divergent thinking in science. Let us have a poem on shadow. One of the teacher will help me to read this poem on shadow. Yes. One of you please volunteer for this. Please read this poem on shadow, based on a scientific concept. When you're teaching shadow, you can reinforce the concept of shadow by this poem or similar type of poem. Yes, one of you. Zainab ma'am, please read.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Scary shadow. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Scary Shadow by Celia Beryl. My shadow on a sunny day, when standing clear of any tree, starts at my feet and makes a shape of black that looks a bit like me. But when it's dark, a table lamp will cast a shadow on the wall. And down the hall, the shape it formed will hardly look like me at all. The shadow from a light close by creates a kind of monster shape that slither round the walls and doors like vampire in their long black cape. When lights are dim, the shapes look weird. We conjure up all kind of glooms that there are no monsters, vampire, ghosts. It's just the shadow in the room. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Zainab ma'am. Thanks a lot. So this is how the concept like reflection, rainbow, shadow, that can be used to make those concepts can be incorporated in poem. You can tell children to make some poem on those concepts, or you introduce some poem on those concepts. That will give some concrete idea that gives them some amount of interest will develop about those concepts. So here you can have this kind of worksheet at elementary stage for children, where they will, this will take care of the spelling errors in science. So this kind of activity where you can give them a worksheet where they will find some words like tortoise, camel and all that, when they're learning all those in science, so that will take care of the spelling errors. This kind of worksheet will be really very helpful. Then mnemonics. Mnemonics are the aid to the memory. They will help memory. It will enhance memory. Like in chemistry, when you have to learn all those difficult elements or those elements which have difficult symbols to memorize and to recollect, mnemonics are of great help. Like first 20 elements are recommended for the grade 10 by CBSE. So this becomes very interesting to them, and it will be a very great help to the memory actually. So here you can have hello, hello, listen to BBC News. On Friday night, some men are selling pizza, so contact Argan Pizza Company. So here you will be help to the memory to recollect those suggested 20 elements with their symbols. So since we are learning about the elements, let us see one video on chemistry, where a very interesting video on how nature of the elements can be done with such funny videos. I hope you will enjoy. Let us see a video on the nature of elements. How elements behave, you can easily find out with the help of this video.
Ma'am, we can't see.
Okay, screen is visible to everyone here? Yes?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Chemistry party here?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
interesting, teachers? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Cute, ma'am.
Yes, so the nature of the elements, you know, with such interesting videos. Okay. Next, we will go for some more. Now, the reflection of light, once you teach children in the elementary or smaller classes, they know about reflection. When they go to some higher classes like grade 9, when they learn about reflection of light, things remain abstract with them. So you have to show them some concrete pictures, depiction, illustration. This kind of pictures will show them the application of reflection or refraction of light in day-to-day life. What is the effect of reflection of light? They know the reflection of light, the effect of reflection, but the refraction of light remain abstract with them. And we will not forget to mention about the refractive index of the diamond, the extraordinary brilliance of the real diamond because of the highest refractive index. And in chemistry, we can include the hardest substance known, that is the allotrope of carbon, that is diamond. So refraction, there you can integrate with physics as well as in chemistry. And refraction of light with such concrete examples you can give, and the effect of refraction of light can be explained in physics. Then how reflection and refraction differ. This is one of the very good image I found where you will see the effect of reflection and how refraction is different from reflection. So that becomes the concept of the scientific concepts becomes more interesting and concrete to them. Isn't it, teachers? Yes, you all agree?
Yes.
So now, in organ system in human, when you're teaching,
yes,
you
yes,
have so many organ systems in our syllabus to teach. We have a SCP system, we have then we have a human digestive system, we have reproductive system. So where you have three-dimensional images will help them to actually identify how these organs look like. So instead of just giving them diagram to label, you have to show them the three-dimensional structure of this kind of organs in a body. Like for a very good example, here of an eye, you can show the 3D with the labeling. So they actually will relate to what exactly an eye look like, an eyeball. Then you will have human digestive system. Give them a real image of that. Give them a 3D images where they can actually identify these organs, and you can discuss the functions of each and every part of the organ. You have a video on this to show three-dimensional and where children will be easily able to identify these organs and their functions. The human digestive system I have covered. There are many more which are not possible. So I have covered human digestive system. Here you can see a video on this where the three-dimensional video will actually explain how it works. So y'all can see the screen, teachers? Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. So here we go.
The complex food that we eat needs to be broken down into simple glucose, fatty acid, amino acid, etc. Only then our body can absorb these liquefied nutrients and use them. This process called digestion happens in the digestive tract that starts from mouth or the oral cavity and ends at the anus. In the mouth, the food is chewed by teeth and mixed with saliva and turned into bolus, a slimy ball. Then through pharynx, it enters esophagus. If you talk, The food may enter windpipe as pharynx is common entry point of windpipe and esophagus. Peristalsis of digestive tract and slimy mucus keep pushing food throughout the digestive tract. Stomach disinfects food and prepares the food for chemical treatment with hydrochloric acid. It also digests protein and little bit of fat. Around 6 meter long small intestine completes the rest of digestion with the help of enzymes it produces and also the enzymes from the pancreas and bile juice from the liver. Large intestine also absorbs the nutrients. So around 1.5 meter long large intestine basically absorbs water out of undigested food. Liver that produces bile for fat digestion, gallbladder that stores bile, and pancreas which produces many enzymes for digestions are not the part of digestive tract as the food doesn't pass through them. As digestion is a chemical process, absence or lack or even excess of any chemical involved in it may cause some problem. So, eat healthy and drink adequate.
So, that was a video on human digestive system. We'll go back to the presentation here. We have very less time left. So, let me. So, now history, how can you integrate art with history? Here you can have collage work. You can encourage children to do collage work on some historical events like India's freedom struggle or French Revolution or Industrial Revolution in India. Make them do a collage so that a particular event in one collage. That makes the concept or the event of that particular time become gives a clearer idea to them. So that kind of collage work can be done in history. When you're teaching about ancient coins, encourage them to give them a project to make some coins with the help of a clay and metallic paintings. This will give them some concrete idea, give them some concept about the Roman coins or what all ancient coins we are under your study. So virtual museum, you have one more video here. I will share a link with you all for this virtual museum tour. There's no time actually to actually take you all to this virtual museum tour. There you 360 degree virtual museum where you can actually rotate the screen. And it is very interesting for the children. So you can take them to this virtual museum where now we are online. So it's not possible to take them offline. That's why we can have this kind of virtual museum tour and it will be very interesting to them. A 360 degree video where you can actually rotate the screen. I will share a link with you all. You can try with your device. So because of the time constraint, I cannot show you. Here you can encourage them for the ancient civilization by painting on the Diwali lamps which you have. You encourage them to paint some ancient civilization. You can give that effect of the remains of the ancient times like Harappan's ceramic pottery and all. So these kind of activities can be encouraged where this Harappan civilization will not be only in the books. They actually will try some of the pottery work on a Diwali Diya, which you can try all this. So geography, how are we going to do geography? How can we have some of the artwork in geography here? Or you again can have a virtual visit to a forest. Take them to a forest, not actually we are taking them, but we are in a virtual tour, describe the climate, about the flora and the fauna, about the biodiversity, there with the help of the virtual videos. This will be of great help. So this does not remain in the book and they just think of the abstract about the abstract concept about the forest, like a rainforest. So that you have ample of resources. Your origami finds its way, finds its scope in many subjects. Here I have, I'm talking in how you integrate with geography here. You can tell them to make origami on some animals which are endangered. So the student can make origami. This is a beautiful artwork through which they will learn about the endangered animals. And very interesting one here. Then Lego art in geography where the map work, you encourage the Lego artwork. That will make the artwork more concrete to them where hands-on learning by doing playway method, they're going to learn the map work in geography. So Lego artwork again is a very interesting way of doing map work, not only map work, it will find its way in many other subjects. So when you are doing the rotation of the earth, a 3D GIF can be used like this, where you can actually show them the rotation of the earth on its own axis. You can show them the global map. You can show them, you can actually ask them to locate India in this 3D GIF. And you can actually talk about the gravity disturbance. So this kind of 3D GIF will help teachers and the students to make the concept in geography very interesting. Okay, so the natural disaster at the, for the elementary level, yeah, for the smaller children, by some cartoon characters or by some animation, you can show them the wildfire, the drought, the flooding, earthquake. All these natural disasters can be explained with this kind of animated depictions. Will be interesting for the children. A map not only used in doing map work in the book or in the paper, in your real life, you actually need these symbols. So acquaint them with this kind of symbols, not only for the academic purpose, but it will find a great importance in the real life as well. So need to familiarize children with this kind of symbols. Best geography app you have over here, I find one. So you can go over here for various resources in geography. So finally, here I'm going to come to wind up the presentation because no time left actually. The greatest effect on student learning occur when the teachers become learners of their own teaching and when students become their own teacher. So this is what we are going to end up with some good thoughts. To practice any art, no matter how well or badly, is a way to make your soul grow. So do it. Thank you, teachers. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, ma'am, for a lovely session.
Thank you, ma'am. Lovely session.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. It was a really lovely session, ma'am.
I have a level best, but I will give you a few of them.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. It was nice. Thank you, ma'am. It was a wonderful session. Thank you so much, ma'am. Wonderful session. Thank you, teachers. Thank you for joining. Thank you for such a wonderful audience. Thank you, Rabu, ma'm. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Rabu, ma'am. Thanks, thanks, everyone. Thank you, thanks a lot.
Yeah, attendance links already shared two times. In the first also and second also. You want?
Attendance link is shared already by...
Yes, ma'am.
Kathy,
yes,
ma'am. Twice she has shared.
Thank you, Kathy, ma'am.
Thanks, Rabu. Awesome session.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Thanks for joining.
Really. Enjoyed thoroughly. And thanks, Kashmira, for the technical aspect too.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone.